Most distribution companies spend significant part of sales and marketing budgets in trade promotions. This is a case of an automotive spare parts company, which has taken a radically different approach and questioned the fundamental way in which the sales and marketing budget should be utilized. Hello.
Hello. I was waiting for you. Your company is very uncaring and ruthless. I'm very angry and disappointed with your company. Your company gives so many gifts to customers, like fridge, TV, music system, and at the same time, your margin for us is very less. Credit also is only 15 days. You aren't doing anything for us.
Sir, you are important for us. Without you, we cannot sell our products. You keep our range of products. These reach out to the customers only because of your presence. How can we ignore you? Do you really feel that we are doing nothing for you?
Yes, you are not doing anything for us. You do everything for the end customers only. Look at your competitors. They have such attractive schemes for us. Not only are they offering better margins than you, plus their distributors give us good credit period of 45 to 60 days. And your distributor is very uptight about a credit of only 15 days.
If we do all that our competition does, will you be able to sell more?
Yes, why not?
Assume we do everything that you ask for. Please let me know, how will you sell more?
We will convince the customer and convert the demand from one brand to other.
Really? Okay, then I have few questions for you. Which is the oldest stock of any company you are carrying in your shop?
Well, difficult for me to say at the moment. I need to check.
When did you purchase this product?
Last year. I bought it in the last year's combo scheme.
Is this product the wrong application?
No, it is the right product.
Why have you not sold it till now? It is lying for more than a year. How much will you earn on this?
Now we will earn 600 rupees. That is 50% more than the earlier price. Thanks to the increase in price during the period.
Since you are still keeping it, are you waiting for some more price increase?
No, we aren't able to sell it.
Why are you not able to sell it? Is this product category not in demand?
Product is in demand, but customers buy other brands. This XYZ brand is not in demand in our market.
But you just said, if you are given a good margin, you can shift customers to the brand you want to sell. Most of the time, when customers want some specific brand, do you try and change him to a different brand?
When I have availability of the required brand, I would not want to change his decision, particularly when the brand is good.
Why not? What if the brand given by you does not perform as per expectations?
The customer may not come back to my shop ever. I want the customer to come to my shop regularly. So mostly, I don't take a risk by changing his brand preference.
What you just said means that margin has very limited role in your decision to sell a brand in light of what we concluded. Look at what supplier of XYZ did to your business. You have bought this in a scheme, assuming you will get a net better margin. But the higher margins is not helping.
Yes, you are right.
Now this product might get rusted soon. And you will lose out on the entire buying price. Now tell me, how should a company support a retailer?
Company needs to work on creating market demand and ensure more customers come to my shop asking for the brand.
Is it not true that our customer loyalty programs is helping create demand, which is actually helping you?
Yes.
Now I have another question for you. Is our distributor's salesperson coming every week?
Yes, but your competitor's salesperson also comes every week.
Are you getting delivery of ordered material next day, door delivery?
Yes, but other companies also do the same.
How many days of stock are you carrying of our company's products?
2 weeks.
How many days of stock are you carrying of other companies?
45 to 60 days.
If others are also sending material every week, then the question is, why are you keeping so much stock?
Your distributor delivers all ordered material, but others don't. So we have to keep the other stocks on the higher side to protect our sale.
Can you compare the daily availability of SKUs of competitor with our performance?
Even though we have total inventory of 45 to 60 days of your competitor's products, availability at an individual SKU level is very poor. In some SKUs, we have stocks of more than 6 months of sales, while in others, we are stocked out for many days at a stretch. While in your case, the daily availability is near perfect at an individual SKU level. Stockouts are extremely rare.
What happens if any product is not available with you?
Customers go to another shop. Customers go back not only for one product, but the entire list. Then they may not come to our shop in the future too.
Who do you think is responsible for the above loss to you?
Distributor and the company.
Why do you think our distributor is able to deliver all your orders every time?
He has good availability.
How come our distributor has good availability and others are not able to offer you the same?
You must have done something in your company to ensure availability at your distributor.
Moreover, have you noticed a different behavior from our distributor as compared to competition?
Yes. Your distributor always asks me to buy in small lots and dissuades me from buying bigger lots. Whereas, the competition always has a scheme to push high volumes.
And then you land up in mess of slow-moving stocks like brand XYZ.
You are right.
Would you agree that we are doing something that ultimately benefits you?
Yes.
As per you, what are we doing?
You are doing two important things that matter the most: good availability and ensuring strong demand for your products.
Sir, lastly, all the gifts that we offer, you surely must be having all these at home.
We do have all these things. But more importantly, I can see your company's way of working, giving me better earnings with faster rotation of stock.
Thank you. Hope you aren't annoyed with us anymore.
Oh, no, no.
If a company has a supply chain which provides better rotations to the retailer, then what is the best use of sales and marketing budgets? If primary need of a retailer is high stock rotation, then do trade scheme designed to push stocks jeopardize this need? Do trade promotion schemes actually help increase demand in the long run?